y'all, today I'm going to be talking about pet allergies. Now, allergies, if you have had any experience with a pet who has had allergies, can be a very, very frustrating situation. There are many ways that your pet can exhibit allergies. They can scratch a whole lot, and they also can have runny eyes. And that was Stassi's issue. I know that runny eyes runs in the Shih Tzu breed, so just because your dog has runny eyes doesn't mean that your dog does have allergies. However, I was suspecting that there may be some allergy stuff going on with Stassi, so I decided to get her allergy tested just to make sure that I wasn't giving her anything that could cause allergies, and sure enough, she did come back with some allergens. Now, there are, like I said, other things that can cause tearing in a dog, so just because your dog is tearing doesn't mean that they have allergies. I just wanted to make sure that there wasn't anything that I was giving her that could cause the allergies, and sure enough, like I said, she does have some allergies, which, just like if you are, you know, outside and you're allergic to something, your eyes run, well, the same thing could happen to your pets. So that was something that, you know, I was very, very interested in. Now, it's a very, very simple test. All it is a blood test that your vet does. They just draw some blood and they send it off to a lab. And then it took about a week to get the results in, and then they sent me the results showing everything that she is allergic to. Now, the allergy testing is not 100%, but it does give you a very, very good idea of things that could be causing allergies in your dog. So I highly recommend, you know, if you suspect any allergies at all, to get them allergy tested. Now, my test at my vet costs $350, so it's not cheap. However, I do believe that this will, you know, more than pay for itself in, you know, vet bills, or, you know, by avoiding the vet bills that could be caused from allergies. So, like I said, Stassi never really scratched, but she did have those watery eyes. So, when I got my testing back from the vet, it came in this little booklet right here. So, they give you a nice little booklet, and the company that my vet used was something called the Spectrum Group, Spectrum Labs. And they give you this nice little booklet that explains all of the allergies that your pet is allergic to. And I will show you what that looks like. So when you open up the book, right here on this side, everything that is in red are the things that she tested positive for. Now, some of these items are environmental, and then some of them are food related. There's not really much that you can do for environmental allergies, because some of the things that she's allergic to, there's no way that I could possibly, you know, eliminate those from her environment. However, they do make up allergy shots, allergy injections that you can get tailored to your pet's allergies. So what they do is look at what your pet is allergic to, and then they take those allergens and they make a special serum into an injection. And then the owner can then give their pet allergy injections to build up the immunity for those particular items. And then hopefully that works in, you know, giving them some protection against the things that they are sensitive to. Now, as far as food allergies, they don't make up any kind of serum or anything for that. What they do for that is they would just, you would just, as an owner, just not give those particular food items. So it's avoidance. So that's the treatment for any type of food allergies. That was the most important thing that I wanted to get out of this allergy testing, is to know exactly if she was allergic to any specific proteins or anything in her food and treats that I was giving her, because that for sure you can easily avoid. So sure enough, like I said, these are the things that Stassi is allergic to in the red. And in the food category, she's allergic to corn, which she doesn't get anything with corn anyway. She's allergic to white potato, sweet potatoes, green peas, And let's see, I know she's allergic to beef, eggs, and soybean. So all those are all of the things that she's allergic to. Now, from what my vet said, the soybean is going to be the most toughest thing to stay away from. The reason why is because a lot of things that are natural, organic, etc., are preserved with what they call mixed tocopherols, and that usually comes from the soybean plant. So in looking at every single label that we have come across for foods and for treats mainly, because she eats her raw and that doesn't have anything in it, just about everything says it's preserved with the mixed tocopherols. So that means that it has soybean in it. So that has been a little bit of a challenge. So what I do with that is I just test it out. And if it's something that I want to give her, then I will give it to her and watch her eyes. And if they start watering, then I know that it has a little bit too much of the soybean in it and to where she is sensitive to that. She eats the frozen raw, and that has absolutely no mixed tocopherols in there. So we don't have to worry about that. However, at nighttime, I do give her the True Dog freeze-dried raw. That does have the mixed tocopherols in that. I did call the company and I spoke with them at length about that because I really, really wanted to feed that in the evenings for her and for Harper and Chi-Chi in Paris. But they said that the amount is just very, very small and for me to try it. And sure enough, I tried it and she didn't react at all to it. So thank goodness she is able to eat that without any problems, even though it probably does have a little bit of soybean in it. So the environmental things that Stassi is allergic to is grass, like a couple of different kinds of grasses, orchids, fescue, ragweed, cocklebur, sage, willow, box elder maple, mulberry, sycamore, so some trees, grasses, yeast, which is aspergillus. I think that's a yeast. I'm not really sure on that. Rhizopus, I guess that's how you say that. I think that's a yeast as well. And Candida albicans, which definitely is yeast. So she is allergic to yeast, which I think is pretty common, like yeast and fungi. She is also allergic to house dust, so the dust mites. And the big one environmentally that she is allergic to is cotton, which I would have never guessed that you can have an allergy to cotton. And if you remember in any of my early videos, I was using those little cotton rounds to wipe and clean her face with. And so I had to switch from using that to Viva paper towels. And the reason why I use Viva is because they're very, very soft, they're very strong, they're very absorbent, but they contain no cotton. So she, you know, seems to be doing well with that. So that's what I use to clean her face with now. So, it's a challenge. I mean, and just because, you know what your pet is allergic to doesn't mean that it's going to fix the problem. It just gives you a heads up on the things that you can control in their diet and in their environment. She doesn't go outside to potty in the grass, so that's good. So we don't have to worry about that. But if we did, then I would suspect that she would probably be itching and that I would have to, you know, put her on some sort of allergy injections for that. But luckily, she doesn't have to, you know, do any of that. So they tell you in here about the food. So these are the foods that she is allergic to, and they tell you that you would just need to avoid those foods as the treatment for food allergies. And then they give you quite a big list of different foods that do not have the items that she is allergic to. So it's let's see, 2 pages, 4 pages, and it's foods and treats. So that's really helpful. Actually, it's like 6 pages. So 6 pages of different foods. I guess they just plug it into a computer and then it spits out the things that she would do, seem to do okay on. So that's really good. Also, in this part of the little booklet, it gives you an allergy overview and it tells you about common allergy symptoms. So it says, just like humans, dogs, and cats can have allergies, and more than 30% of all skin irritations in these animals can be attributed to allergies. Allergens can be found in foods, in something inhaled, like weeds, trees, grass pollens, molds, insects, carpet fibers, and even other pets. And that the onset for allergies usually is between 6 months and 3 years of age. So if if you have a tiny puppy and they have, runny eyes, don't think that, oh, they have allergies. It could very well just be that they're puppies and they're teething and things like that. Also, it gives you a breakdown of the types of allergens. So it tells you exactly like what is an inhalant allergen, what is contact allergens, flea allergens, and food allergens. So it gives you lots of good information on that. And then it just goes on and tells you just lots and lots of information that's really, really helpful. Things like how does being allergic to cockroaches can affect your pet? And so it gives you a whole paragraph on that. Mold allergens and how it can affect your pet. And then it gives you the things that she is allergic to that I was telling you, the Aspergillus and the Rhizopus and the Candida albicans. So then I would just read in this, like Aspergillus is found in soil, damp hay, on grains, and on fruits. The Rhizopus is typically found in children's sandboxes and clusters of pine needles and leaves. Sweet potato, which she is allergic to, strawberries, stewed fruit, and the feathers and droppings of wild birds. The Candida albicans, it says very seldomly found as an airborne mold spore. They are common in soil, organic debris, and in humans, in the nasal, pharynx, and feces. So it gives you lots and lots of information on each individual thing that your pet is that comes up allergic to. It also gives you a guide on how to allergy proof your home. So things like making your home a non-smoking environment, which ours is. Check for gaps and cracks and leaks and seal with any kind of waterproofer. Carpet is never good. So if you have carpet, that's a big no-no for anyone or any pet that has allergies, because things just get trapped in there and you just can't get it clean. So that's something that you can do to allergy proof your home as well. Mold inspection. So inspect your house for, visible signs of mold. So it gives you lots of good information. So I think this is well worth the $350 that it cost me to get this done. And I highly suggest, if you have a pet that has any kind of symptoms, that you look into it with your vet and see if it's something that you think would be beneficial to you and your pet. So I hope this answered, some of your questions about allergies. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the description box below. And that concludes this video. We'll catch you guys on the next one, and hope you're having a great day wherever you are. Bye guys.